Yeah, I know I'm mega talented, and you know, sometimes I am unpredictable. But you know, that's something that them snooker players have to, you know, have in their frame of mind every time they go out to play me. Is he going to knock in 5 centuries in the best of 9, or is he going to, is he not going to play so well? But even my bad game there seems to be good enough to beat most players. So, you know, I'm not really bothered. No one really scares me, and I'm just, you know, as long as I feel good in my game, then I expect to beat everyone that I play.
Yes, there's no point in being modest about it all, is there? Good evening. Ronnie O'Sullivan there, showing no fear of the unknown, but he faces a virtual unknown in our big match here tonight. It's a fellow called John Reed. He's ranked 85 in the world. He comes from Wolverhampton. This is the third round stage of the Grand Prix here in Bournemouth, the first ranking tournament of the season. And despite the loss of a whole clutch of famous names, they've gone Hendry, Doherty, Ebden, Davis, the title holder, Mark Williams. The players making the early running this season appear to be holding their form. This is based on the 3 tournaments played so far, 2 invitationals in China, plus the Regal Masters in Motherwell, and that's not a ranking one either, and the top 6 all getting through their first round matches here in Bournemouth. But all of the next 7 on the money won so far this season have gone. They're all out. And what a magnificent 7 they are, or were. Well, O'Sullivan, as you saw, is currently 3rd on that list this season, but his form here, you know, it hasn't been that remarkable. He struggled to a 5-4 win over Bradley Jones in the first match he played. Well, his match tonight coming up. First of all, let's hear John Virgil's views on the strengths and weaknesses of the headline maker.
In the days when they say there's no characters in the game of snooker, no one to excite the crowd, get them on the edge of their seats since the likes of Alex Higgins, along comes Ronnie O'Sullivan. Certainly one of the most natural talents the game has ever seen. His potting ability, break building, and all-round snooker brain is on a level I've never seen before. His maximum break in 5 minutes 20 seconds may never be equaled.
Maximum break, that is. Ronnie O'Sullivan's delighted. The crowd's delighted. 5 minutes for one. Unbelievable maximum break. Sensational.
The speed in which he can size up situations and the skill in which he takes advantage of them makes him probably the most exciting snooker player to ever hold a cue. Sometimes he seems to be hitting the cue ball while it's still moving.
Well, speeding up now, John Street on a job game. 39. Balls on the pockets. But the crowd love it. And don't we all?
Naturally right-handed, he's a player who's made century breaks left-handed and has used this in major ranking events to the dismay of his opponents. Says he just does it to entertain himself and the crowd. However, all that natural talent, that quickness of decision sometimes can cost you.
That's a careless one.
13.
Very Ronnie careless Sullivan. From Ronnie. He won't be happy with that.
Because the old saying goes, no matter how good you are, when you're sat down and your opponent's potting the balls, you're going to lose. And that's the only real weakness Ronnie has. As with Alex Higgins, they have so much belief in their ability to be able to play any shot on the table. Occasionally, they just play that one shot too many. With all that charisma and talent, he's still, however, somewhat of an enigma. There's been times when he's fallen foul of authority, loses matches and threatens to retire. But we've got to remember, he's only young and naturally a little bit naive and wears his heart on his sleeve. But I believe when he gets everything together, I don't think there's anything in the game of snooker he can't achieve.
Yes, all the headlines on one side, and the man he's playing tonight has struggled to make a paragraph. John Reed, 28 years old, Wolverhampton, 7th year as a professional. To be honest, he hasn't done very much in those 7 years. He's played Ronnie O'Sullivan once in his career and lost. It's the best of nine, as you know, in this third round. Here's the opening frame. It's in progress. John Reed just has the edge at the moment by 3 points, and you'll hear commentary from Dennis Taylor and Ray Edmonds. Reed in play.
He needed a thin contact, not quite that thin, and now trouble.
There's always great excitement
and 16.
Anticipation when Ronnie O'Sullivan plays this game.
17.
The last few tournaments he's been playing left-handed as well as right. Really the only player in the history of the game that
24.
Can play to such a high standard with both hands.
Not such a good shot, still got the yellow on, but not quite as easy as it might have been.
27.
But now back in near perfect position.
27.
Well, that was an unexpected miss from Ronnie. And he hasn't got the red safe. It's landed over the other pocket for John, so this is a nice little starter here.
One.
It's got the loose red to play for. He's got a nice angle to go into the red, so he may just play for the loose one this time.
Yeah.
I think he feels as if he had a bad contact there, so that just stopped the cue ball from going a little bit further up the table. The red's still on, but he's going away from the black now. In fact, just looking at the angle, he may not be able to hold for the pink or blue, so he may have to go further up the table.
No. John Reed, no.
Well, that could have finished worse. He's left a red to the left corner, but not easy from close to the cushion, and he needs to get this one.
21.
And that's a good shot when Ronnie O'Sullivan is waiting to come to the table. He always seemed a little more difficult, but that was right in the middle of the pocket, and great chance now for John Reed.
Well, it looks as if he may have covered the red that he played for. Or can he just get through to it? Maybe just. And as you can see, the other two reds are now available into the same pocket. He hasn't got the angle to get on those two this time. And that's a pretty poor positional shot.
16.
Great character away from the table, John Reid. I remember travelling to Bangkok with him and back in 1992 and had a lot of fun in his company. He's pulled a little gem out there. That was a terrific pot and the perfect angle to get on the two reds now. Twenty-five. 31.
Well, again, just a little short of pace, but he's still okay. And well, it might work for him here if he drops nicely onto the yellow or down there. He may get an angle to move that last red. Is he hard enough? So the next positional shot, he may be able to get across from the green, but this one's a big shot, 17 points in front. If he can't get onto the last red, he could well take the frame here.
34. Very promising start this from John Reid. He's just a couple of balls away from taking the first frame off Ronnie O'Sullivan.
38.
23 points the difference. So the yellow and the green.
Well, this is just the kind of start this young man wanted. Had a terrible season last year, didn't get to the final venues of any of the ranking tournaments.
47.
Lost in all the qualifiers, so he's won two matches already here and off to a good start in this third one.
52. 58.
And he certainly looked very cool around the table. I think the crowd are a little shocked. They know Ronnie O'Sullivan ever so well. They don't know this young man, but a great start for the young man from Wolverhampton, winning the opening frame.
Well, no rocket Ronnie yet. That took 14 minutes and Reid won it. Here's the second, and Ronnie O'Sullivan with just a few points on already.
Still a little bit of a careless one from Ronnie there. Too thick a contact. Brought the red back down with the cue ball. But it's not a clear-cut chance.
One.
Oh, nice round of applause there. Well deserved. That was very good cueing to knock that in. And if he can get himself onto a red, the yellow's the best colour to take to get position. But they're all covering each other, so he's got to be very precise with this.
Foul stroke. One, John Reed. Four, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Well, that's unlucky. He played that one well. He's left Ronnie a couple of reds on, one to the corner and one to the middle, but they're both going to want very good shots to get nicely onto a colour.
One.
He's on the blue, but the wrong side. That looks good. He's got a possible chance here of disturbing the two reds to the left of the black. Just enough angle on that red to the right of the two, and he'll need a little bit of luck here, but he could finish on the black. He'll settle for that. All of a sudden, it's a good scoring opportunity.
Thirty-one.
Well, there's absolutely nothing that John Reed could do about this. It was a very good shot that he played when potting the yellow. Very unfortunate to knock the red in, but it looks as if he's going to lose the frame through that bad misfortune.
Forty-six, 47, 54, 55.
Nothing he can do. Just sit and perhaps admire the way that Ronnie O'Sullivan has taken advantage
62.
Of that piece of bad luck.
63.
Just over 3 minutes to make a 70 break.
It's when he's like this, 71. Ray, it always reminds me of a bingo caller, the referee. Ronnie's going so fast, the way he's calling the scores out.
78.
And he would make a good bingo caller, our Len Ganley, one of the great characters in the game.
79.
He thought he'd gone in off there, was walking to the chair. He's got to come back to play the next shot, but the frame is over and done with. And hope to disturb the yellow, but nevertheless a superb 86 break.
86. And Priam?
And he's not bothering with what was left, so Ronnie O'Sullivan, level at one frame each.
Yeah, he didn't want any more of that. That's more like O'Sullivan. Well, Reed now knows you make one mistake and let the man in. And as we join frame three, Reed has made another one. On a nice little opening flurry, and he's missed a very potable pink. And O'Sullivan is back.
A little bit scrappy this frame with the colours getting tied up earlier. It's starting to open up now, but this will probably suit John Reed. Just give him a chance to settle in.
What? Six. Seven.
Things aren't particularly straightforward from here. Just the one red to the right there will go. Unless he pots this one, I think the cue ball will go into the other red, so to the right of it, so it's certainly not straightforward. And now with a decision to make, and I think it's probably made for him in as much as he can't hit anything other than the black or pink. So he's going to have to go for this pink, but very, very difficult shot.
Yes, there was quite a bit of pressure on John to knock that in, and from the cushion, it was an excellent result.
21.
And this is an excellent effort from John Reed. He seems to be relaxing minute by minute out there. Looks very comfortable.
27.
Now he's opened the reds up nicely, but he's got a little bit of manoeuvring to do with the cue ball here. He's got the red in the right corner, and he might be able to just get back through the gap for the pink. Great chance to go on now and take this third frame. Already 46 points in front. You won't get them placed much better than this.
34. 35.
Well, he's having the cue ball cleaned. I'm not sure if he got a kick there. I think he just got into that one a little bit too well. Not quite as straightforward as it would have been.
Red, a colour, and one more red to virtually make sure of this third frame. But this frame, I think, has been played, if you like, to suit John, perhaps more than Ronnie. Ronnie gets a little impatient when it becomes a bit of a scrappy tactical battle. Likes to get on with the game.
You're still going to need a red after the color, but that's well, this is the third shot he's had to play with a rest or an extended rest. Sooner or later he
42,
was
John Reed.
Going to miss one. He can't keep knocking him in with the long stuff. So John not quite over the line in this frame. Still plenty points there for Ronnie. But not if he's going to play shots like that. John's getting plenty of practice in with his extension and
one.
Well, he's played that one well and now 59 on the table, 61 points in front. Pink will take this frame beyond Ronnie O'Sullivan's reach. So this young man from Wolverhampton.
Seven.
Got off to a good start. Then this young man played a very good frame, very quick. 86 break to level it, but John's not been upset by that. And he is the kind of player that you really can't take liberties with. Very
14.
Steady and consistent and certainly showing no signs of fear of his opponent or his opponent's reputation. And into the lead at two frames to one goes John Reed.
Although Sullivan took the next to go into the interval at two frames all, Reed came back to take frame five. So far, O'Sullivan has never led in this match. Have a look at frame six, and O'Sullivan is much better. He's got a 36-0 lead, and here he's on a break of 17. Going well.
17, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Well, that wasn't difficult, so I don't think it was pressure. I think it just took it a little bit, perhaps, too easy. Can't afford to do that.
Yes, he had very little angle with that, so he's left himself with a very tricky black along the top cushion. That's pretty close. That's a good effort.
Eight.
He's a little bit hampered here with the cueing for the easy red just above the black, but he still may have to, well, he can get the other one into the right corner and maneuver the cue ball around the back of the black.
Nine.
And the reds have opened up somewhat. When Ronnie missed the pink, it moved a few of those reds. So this is a good chance for John Reed now.
Twenty-four.
And the reason this is such a good performance from John Reed, he's never really played
32
on television in the UK. He did in 1992 play on television in the Asian Classic out in Bangkok. So he's very inexperienced with the television lights and cameras, but he's certainly coping very well in this match with everything.
Certainly the four remaining reds are in potable positions. He's got to be fairly accurate with the cue ball, but he's got what appears to be about the perfect angle on them to put the cue ball where he wishes. John had a very close match with Dean Reynolds in the first round here, just
48,
winning by the odd frame, 5-4, but then a very good win against a very good player from Liverpool, Rod Lawler, to earn this place in the last 32. And just where he got to the stage where it was fairly straightforward, he misses a fairly simple one. And that could be costly.
One.
That's a little smile from Ronnie there. Tells you what he thinks of that shot.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, one.
And that's a little bit careless as well, so things certainly not going Ronnie's way at the moment.
Yes, and Ronnie only scoring one off that slip up from John Reid will have done John's confidence no harm whatsoever. Well, now, he's been a little bit lucky. The cue ball going near the cushion, but this is on to the middle. But inches away from the pocket.
I think Ronnie's got himself under a lot of pressure now, and that's the reason he's missing. John is getting away with it slightly. You know, he left the cue ball close to the side cushion there, and that was the reason Ronnie missed the pots. He normally would knock them in, but he's definitely under pressure out there now.
Six.
Well, you would have to say that if he knocks this one on and finishes on blue or black, the frame's there for the taking.
Seven.
I'm pretty sure the blue will go past the black and the yellow goes past the black, so it really is pretty straightforward. There you see it. So, yellow and green to make sure. And this young man has got to win three frames in a row now to stay in this year's Grand Prix. And, well, as I said earlier on, he's going to really have to up his game. He's going to have to go up a notch and produce the kind of form 17. He's capable of, because I think John Reid will still play at a fair level.
And the frame.
Ronnie concedes, so a shot maybe in the offing. John Reid, 4-2 in front of many people's favourite, Ronnie O'Sullivan. Attempt from Ronnie, and he's left one to the middle. I'm not sure that when you are in trouble that you should try and hit yourself out of it. Maybe that's the time you should be extra patient.
One.
Yes, and without doing a great deal of work with three or four loose reds, John has got a chance to get an early lead here.
Seven.
But there is going to be a lot of pressure on the young man. This would be the biggest win of his career to get the scalp of Ronnie O'Sullivan. would be such a feather in his cap. And Ronnie knows he's right up against the wall here.
Twenty-two.
Hasn't quite worked out. He almost knocked a red into the right center pocket, but he's covered that one. You can see can't get through to that, and this is a very tricky one along the top cushion. Big shot.
23.
He's coping with the pressure very well at the moment. It's John Reed.
31. 33.
Pretty sure that'll be a very anxious supporter of Ronnie O'Sullivan. The look tells you that she
34.
Can see this match drifting away from the favourite. He hasn't played well so far this evening, but not to take anything away from his opponent. His opponent has stuck to his task and stood up to all the pressure. He's still got a bit to do, though.
39. 40.
Just a little bit of adrenaline there. Overscrewed that shot. Wanted to be nicely on the blue. But there is a red to the left of the pink that could be available. And if the one at the back of the little bunch of reds is available, he can get up to that from the green.
43.
I think he may have gone a little bit too far for the one he intended.
43.
But the back one of those reds is not available. He might just be able to get the one next to it. That would be a bonus. He didn't intend to be on that one.
44.
I don't think it's going to be in the way of this red. John had had a good look. There you see it.
52.
And this next shot could be a match winner. I feel he's got to go into the pack off the blue. And a little bit of luck this time, and Ronnie O'Sullivan may be out of the Grand Prix. Didn't get into it full enough.
57.
So 57 point lead isn't enough to be absolutely sure. I think the single red to the right might go to the middle pocket, but I really can't think that he should be taking it on. Well, it does, but there's no future in it, really. As you see there, the white will go into the other reds. It's a very difficult pot. And he's got the points on the board, and it's up to Ronnie O'Sullivan now to get himself back into this match. He really is up against it.
Want to catch the knuckle on the middle pocket, but at least the cue ball has gone close to the side cushion. This is a tough shot. It may be worth the risk. He could get onto the black, and if this red goes in, that gentleman on your screen could be out. That was a tough shot. I think the red that's closest to the white will pass the blue into the corner pocket.
One.
Now, when great champions, when their back's against the wall, that's when they produce their best. He's got to pull all the stops out here. Can he do it?
Eight. Nine. 14.
No, surely not.
Foul stroke.
Well,
14, Ronnie
O'Sullivan. Ronnie is so proficient, left-handed, easily the best in the game, and hit that one so well. First time he's tried it this evening, and going in off means that John Reed wants a red and a colour. But all of a sudden, the tension is showing. Pockets are getting just a little bit smaller to John Reed. Mind you, not getting very easy for Ronnie at the moment either.
Yes, he was a proverbial mile away off that one. And John Reed. This could be the winner.
One.
Yes, I think that's enough.
Well, that's amazing. Wonderful result for John Reed. He knocks out the tournament favourite by 5-2. A fantastic result for this young man.
Well, John Reed, what do you think about all that? Brilliant.
Over the moon. Can't believe it.
Without any doubt, your biggest win?
Yeah, easily. I've waited a long time for something like this. Had a few problems, but I've stuck at it. And just looking forward to the next round now.
The career's been a bit of a struggle, hasn't it? It's been hard work.
Yeah, it's hard work qualifying and that, and there's so many good players coming through. You're having to beat each other, it's really hard. So many can do what I've done tonight.
Oh, can they?
Yeah.
So, they'd like to believe that, I think.
Yeah, there is.
I mean, we know a lot of the big names are gone, but Ronnie's a bit different, isn't he?
Oh, he's different class to me. He's like, if he's on top form, you've got to play out your skin to have a chance. But he didn't play very well tonight, and I did miss a few balls myself, but I was pleased the way I held myself together under the conditions that I've not been used to.
In fact, I think you almost got lost trying to find the venue at one stage. Somebody phoned you walking around the cafe, didn't
you? Yeah, I mean, there's that many doors. It's like a blooming maze. I couldn't believe it. I was all over the place. I thought, I'm going to get Dr. Frey me if I don't hurry up. But I'm just having it. It's not sunk in yet. I'm really happy.
Why do you think you beat him then? I mean, you say he didn't play that well.
I know I could beat him. If I didn't think I could, I wouldn't have. Mm. I mean, it's just, I know I can do it. It's just a matter of doing it. And I've proved to myself tonight that I can do it. So I'm just looking forward to the rest now.
Yeah, well, you've got to believe it again, because you've got a young fella called Tony Drago, haven't you?
That's right, yeah. He played me a couple of years back in the UK and gave
That's
me a
right,
bit of a drubbing.
That's right, about 94, wasn't it?
Yeah, he gave me a bit of a... Well, he beat me 9-7, but he potted well that night. But I'm looking forward to getting me revenge.
In a way, he's the same as Ronnie. I mean, once he gets in,
yeah,
he just stand back.
He's just a complete natural. I mean, to me,
yeah.
Drago's a very, very talented player, but to beat Ronnie, he's like, I'm just over the moon. Yeah. I can't believe it.
I can tell you haven't come down.
No,
you've got
not
to.
Yet. Not yet. I just. Very,
you've done
very.
Well.
Yeah.
Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.
In confirmation of the fact that he does play Tony Drago, because this afternoon Drago beat Paul Wykes, the Bournemouth hero, 5-3. And quite naturally, Tony Drago was here tonight picking up points, and he was studying John Reed, because I'm quite sure he was watching Ronnie O'Sullivan at the start of it all. But that's the situation. And a remarkable situation, really, John Virgil. You were analysing Ronnie O'Sullivan's play for us at the start of the programme. I have to say, I think you had a bit of a crystal ball, because a lot of it came true.
Yeah, well, that's the type of Ronnie player that Ronnie is. I've got to be perfectly honest with you. I mean, he's very disappointed with Ronnie O'Sullivan tonight. I mean, it's a packed house here at the BIC. They've come along to see him. He's the new Jimmy White, Alex Higgins, if you like. And really, he was lucky to be 2-2 at the interval. And then I thought, well, in the second half, he'll turn it on and he'll give the game a bit more respect and he'll give his opponent more respect, and he didn't.
Mm.
And he deserved to go out. And I just thought it was a very disappointing performance, not only from Ronnie's point of view, because that's his own bag, if you like, but the people who came along to see him tonight. I mean, I think Ronnie can do a lot better now. He knows he can, and taking nothing away from John Reed, but he didn't make John Reed work for it at all. You know, I'm very disappointed with Ronnie tonight.
When you say about Ronnie turning it on, in that second frame, he looked like he was turning it on, because suddenly it all came right and John Reed was sitting there and it was Ronnie just flying.
Well, absolutely. But you see, that seems to me Ronnie's attitude occasionally, that if everything's right and the balls are there to be potted, he enjoys that. The other part, the little grafting part of the game, he doesn't enjoy, but that is part and parcel of the game. If it was all as simple as the second frame, I'd be playing myself.
Or all as simple as he said before, quite honestly. But as you pointed out, he does make the odd funny shot. He made a couple of mistakes. I mean, there was one in frame three here, this red. I mean, how does he miss this sort of thing?
Well, it depends really how much of a pocket there was to go at there. I mean, but yes, you certainly expect him to pot that.
Mm.
But later on in the match, as I say, when he was getting to the stage where he couldn't make mistakes, and this was a classic example, this was a big frame. He's 36 points in front. Nice, easy, three-quarter ball, pink in the middle. You can't afford to miss those. And the reason he missed it, he got down and played it too quick, you know.
I mean, he says he's the new Ronnie O'Sullivan. Certainly has calmed down a lot. Mm. He was very immature. I mean, he's not really that grown up yet. Mm. And fitness and everything else. But the attitude and mind seems still to be suspect.
Yeah, well, I suppose when you've got this type of ability that he's got, you know, and I likened him in to Alex Higgins, but Higgins could always spot the danger. And at 2-2, when he was lucky to be 2-2, Higgins would have come out in the second half determined not to give his opponent the chances that Ronnie did. Ronnie just seems to go out and say, oh, well, it all come good. But best of nine, as we all know, you just want a few little bits of bad run and you're out of the tournament. And that's what's happened to Ronnie.
And look at the way the stars are falling. It's these short sprints in the first ranking tournament of the season that's happening again.
Yeah, well, the best of nine is hard, but as you say, there's a lot of lads like John Reed have been playing qualifiers all summer, and they're focused, they match sharp, and they have a slight advantage, but that's, you know, good luck to them.
Thank you, John. a man with a crystal ball. And John Parrott was...